Those pandas are adorable and comforting, while our very own Formosan Black Bears, the mascots would probably outnumber the actual animals. We have a bear mascot, too. Oh, by the way, bear paws and gallbladders are consumed by some people. How cruel! How pitiful! But then what? Today, let me tell you a story about the Formosan Black Bears. Let's show some love to our bears. Let's begin! Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, according to the Bunong legend, the leopard and bear's furs were once playing. One day, when they were bored out of their minds and looking for something to do, the bear put in a lot of effort in painting the leopard's spots, transforming it into the Formosan clouded leopard. While the bear was sleeping, the childish leopard painted the bear's body black, but left a V-shaped area resembling crossed arms on the bear's chest, creating the Formosan Black Bear. According to the legend, as long as painting has been mastered, you can make all sorts of bears, be it a panda, a bichon, or no bida. As the legend was passed down through generations from grandma to grandpa, it lost its sense of logic along the way. But we've also witnessed the relationship between indigenous friends and the Formosan Black Bear. For example, the Bunong call the Formosan Black Bear Hira, and regard it as good partners against foreign invaders. The Truku believe the white V on the bear's chest is like the moon, a symbol of the king of the forest, not to be hunted or killed. More so, the Taiwan believe that killing the bear incites revenge from the bear's spirit. These legends reveal that our indigenous friends regarded the Formosan Black Bear with much reverence and awe. Taiwan used to be a paradise for the Formosan Black Bears and other wild animals. But with the arrival of the modern Han Chinese, the relationship between the humans and the bears began to change. In the eyes of most indigenous people, the bears are like this, while the Han Chinese view the bears as this. As Mencius once said, "I desire fish, and I also desire bear paws." In the Compendium of Materia Medica, Li Shizhen recorded that a bear's gallbladder, bones, flesh, and blood can be used as medicine. These show that for the Han Chinese, the bear, from its head to its toe, all possess high economic value. Apart from satisfying your hunger, a bear's fur can even keep you warm, or it can be made into a status symbol for the rich and wealthy. During the Japanese occupation, the government's deforestation policy further eroded their habitat. That's how the Formosan Black Bear that once dominated the mountains became this land's loneliest wanderer.
台湾黑熊目前遇到最大的问题，从野外研究资料来看，应该是非法狩猎，还有栖息地破坏。目前主要的栖息地都已经局限在山区比较偏远、地形陡峭，再开发就土石流的地方了，或者在保护区里面。所以栖息地的破坏应该再遭也不会有大幅的开发。那另外一个最大的威胁是非法狩猎。根据30只的黑熊样本，有半数是断手断脚的。 而这断手断脚的因素，其实是这种套索。那这种套索可以放在森林里面100就上百个。这些陷阱虽然是造成熊死亡的元凶，但是绝大部分都不是为了黑熊而绑。大部分的猎人其实并不是拿来抓黑熊，主要是抓像这个就是抓山猪啊，那这可能是山羊。就汉人来讲，熊从头到尾都值钱。其中一个最重要的因素是有中药文化，因为啊熊胆的关系，因为熊 长征修的缘故，所以让熊甚至现在可以卖到1-20万。所以我现在要说的其实是杀死熊的不是猎枪，而是老饕或者我们的消费习惯。但是还有一个影响面更大的间接因素，是我们对台湾黑熊的不了解，也因为不了解，因此我们不关心，甚至我们会变成是共犯。我们有时候甚至会去吃生产，甚至是买黑熊的产制品。因此，如果能够更多的机会认识我们这块岛屿上的黑熊，我认为台湾黑熊的数量要增加，其实是十分指日可待的事情。
Towards the end of the Bunong legend, because the Formosan Black Bear was teased by the Formosan Clouded Leopard, the brothers cut off contact with each other. To show remorse, the Formosan Clouded Leopard only consumed the internal organs of his prey and left the rest on the path that the black bear frequents. After hundreds of years, the black bear might have cooled down, or may still be angry at the Clouded Leopard for hiding from him. But what the black bear doesn't know is that the Clouded Leopard has become extinct as a result of human activities, never to return again. Legends may just be legends, but in the grand scheme of things in nature, no single entity should be in control of the plot. The appearance of mankind should not mark the end of other species. Only through incorporating a sense of awe and symbiosis can the story of nature continue to unfold.